Now look at this.
What's up, about pain with Sarah New Topic 5.1 on meiosis.
So there's a lot of stuff to unpack on this one, so it may end up being two videos, so I'm gonna apologize in advance. So just like in mitosis, before we go into meiosis, we're gonna have to go through interphase. So it goes through the G1 to grow, S phase, so that we can make a copy of the DNA, and then through G2, where we can, of course, grow some more. And just like in mitosis, we have prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. You're gonna notice that there's a one behind each of those. What that means is that we're actually gonna have two prophases, two metaphases, two anaphases, and two telophases. Why? Because we go through two rounds of division. Process of meiosis is going to be producing gametes. Gametes are going to be haploid. So we're going to replicate the DNA once, but we're going to divide the cell twice so that we can get our cells to only have half the amount of genetic information. Because when you go through fertilization, when two gametes come together, we want it to be back to that diploid number. So just like what we saw in prophase of mitosis, the chromatin is going to condense down into, of course, the sister chromatids. But now we're going to see the homologous chromosomes are going to come together. So we'll have a maternal and a paternal for chromosome 1 are going to pair up and form a tetrad. So as you see here, we have our homologous chromosomes. So they form together to make that tetrad. So four chromatids all lined up together. They're all the same length. It's just that two are maternal and two are paternal chromosomes. So when you look here, we're going to see something called crossing over take place. Non-sister chromatids are going to overlap and exchange genetic information. So if you notice those two inner parts, one is maternal and one is paternal. And so they overlap and exchange genetic information. So you see how the purple C is now on the pink chromosome and the pink C is on that purple chromosome. This is one of the ways that we can reshuffle genetic information to increase the genetic variation. Metaphase, the same thing we saw before, where you'll have the microtubules will attach. We have the same tug of war taking place that's going to allow our homologous chromosomes to line up in that metaphase plate. So the homologous chromosomes can independently allow in the metaphase plate. So here you see if we have only have two chromosomes, the different options. You could have all maternal on one side and all paternal on the other, which ends up leading us to all gametes with all maternal and all paternal chromosomes. Or you see over here that you could have chromosome 1 lining up one way and chromosome 2 lining up a different way, which leads to variation. We as humans have 23 different pairs of chromosomes. So 2 to the 23, that's a lot of different combinations that can take place in our gametes. So this also leads to genetic variation. Anaphase involves the homologous chromosomes segregating to opposite poles. This leads us to the law of segregation that Mendel is going to talk about later. Telophase, I form my two new nuclei. But the thing to notice is that they are haploid at this point. Ms. Jones, how are they haploid? Because you only have one set of chromosomes. It's going to be one chromosome plus its sister chromatid, which is identical.